So next we are going to see in detail about the South Gujarat settlement. Basically, the South Gujarat was occupied more by the tribal community of people in that particular area. So among this, the Kolis are a group of people, and they were like their occupation is agriculture. So they occupied the major area there. Again, the South Gujarat can be understood, the settlement pattern and their architecture can be understood by dividing them into two types, like rural and urban. So if we take the rural house, they have this very primitive structure, like that will be made up of this bamboo or whatever the kind of wood available there. So they will be having some vertical poles. Basic structure will be of vertical poles. And this vertical poles will be covered by wattle and palm. So this is the predominant material they have used in their dwelling units. So with these things, they produced some partitions like that. So this partitions was the one. This partitions was like for both the privacy and for the enclosure they have used this. So initially their dwelling units will be with this particular material. Even the roof will be of slope roof, and again it will be of that bamboo or whatever the wood available there. Again, this dwelling unit can stand by itself or more commonly join others. Basically, how the arrangement was like, all these units will be having a identical height, width and proportions, and all these units will be like narrow. They will be too narrow. So the South Gujarat arrangement comparing with the North is narrow type of arrangement, and this is like a deep rectangle type of arrangement. And this dwelling units, if we take again the first dwelling unit of the particular row, again this will be like wall to wall construction. They will be having the common wall, and this particular first unit will be occupied by one family, and the succeeding units will be the son or daughters of this particular parents. So they will be extending their own territory in this row house type. So after one particular time or one particular development, they terminate this, and they start developing another one unit somewhat distance from this. So they want they don't want a somewhat a closed type of arrangement and somewhat more secure type of arrangement in the South Gujarat. So again, they are agriculture based community. So their women folks will be introduced more, or they will be moving more outside. So for that particular reason, they don't want somewhat enclosed kind of arrangement. So their arrangement will be somewhat like a more dispersed and more improper arrangement, like that unorganized arrangement, we can call it as like that. So this row belonged to the descendants of the common parents, so somewhat like that. So initially this type of arrangement was existing in this particular South Gujarat. So this is the arrangement. So they will be having that upright poles, and that will be connected by horizontal elements again with the bamboo or the wood that is existed there, and they will be covering that with the palm. So initially it was with somewhat a partition kind of thing, and later they started applying the wattle, and that along that wattle they started introducing the mud. So this is for the purpose of creating a more stable and more solid enclosure. So for that purpose they have evolved their structures with the mud. So initially it was like a mud application of mud as a layer, and later that has been transferred into a solid wall construction with the mud. So one interesting feature found in the South Gujarat is the formation of a structural grid. So this was not there in that North Gujarat. Here we can see a very proper formation of a structural grid. And this will be like a series of bays. Initially it were like 3 to 5 bays. So depending upon their space, they extended this number of bays, and the roofs were like more steeper, because they in the South Gujarat area they had more of rainfall. So for that particular reason, what they have gone for is like more steep roofs. And again, this is like a what we saw in the third category of that timber framing. So this will be like this vertical poles will be connected by the beams, and this will be like a complete framed structure. So in the very rural settlement itself, we can witness this. And for extension of the house, what they did is like, for example, if this is the first house, and for extension of the second house, instead of adding the another wall here, this will be this side wall will be acting as a common wall. So a series of dwelling units will be added. So initially, as I have said, they have gone for only the partitions with the upright poles, that is like somewhat like a wooden partition, wooden screen. So they even psychologically had the feeling of so our son is very near to us. It is just this partition which is separating. So physical separation was there, but psychological separation was not there. So that kind of maturity was existing at that period. So that is to be noted here. And so again, somewhat rural a picture of that rural kind of structure. So they was using this roof tiles at that time period. And here, if we go into the planning, so how there are three stages of evolution for this particular rural kind of arrangement. So since these people were the agriculture and the cattle rearing community, so cattle was more important for them. Their plots were like, as I said, it's more deep rectangles. So now how the planning was evolved is like their importance was given to the cattle here. So to the total center of the house, they introduced the cattle. For example, if we take this particular unit, either if we mark the center, so this will be the center, but along the grids, they planned the spaces. So that that is the difference here. So now this cattle has been taken to the center. So that the women community who is inside the house can take care of what's happening here. So usually this kitchen had a rear door. So front door will be there and rear door will be there. So all of the South Gujarat settlement or South Gujarat dwellings, they won't be having this center door. So which is total contrast to the North Gujarat. So they will be having this off-centered doorway. So once we enter the door, we will be having a semi-private space or the public space, we can even call it as. So there's no any veranda. So initial stage, there was a space for the main community and for the visitors, so they can come and leave here. And this, after this, they will be having a narrow passage through which this particular private space can be entered. So again, this rear space will be used for the kitchen and for the sleeping, dining, everything will happen here. In the second stage of development, what they started doing is like they started adding some screening elements here. So with the, again with the wood or whatever the material that is available there. So they started introducing screening for this cattle and screening for this kitchen area. Now this this resembles somewhat a kind somewhat the North Gujarat type of arrangement. So this will be the auto. Before that auto, we will be having the veranda, and here we will be having that khaki space. So all these relations started developing here. And in the final stage, so nothing has shifted out of the grid. The grid remains the same. So only inside the grid they plan. So they will be accessing a veranda, and from the veranda they will be accessing that khaki space or the space for the visitors. And next will be the private space, and rear will be the kitchen. So here from the starting of this rural type of planning till it got transferred to the urban, this kitchen remained at the rear of the building, and also they had this rear door. Usually what how it has happened is like these people while arranging in their settlement pattern, so if we consider this is a row of dwelling units and this is a row of dwelling units, this particular row of dwelling units have, if this is the main entry and this is the rear entry, they have this open space here. So in meanwhile, what they started doing is they started to extend their boundaries somewhat outside, and they started to have a backyard kind of space in the rear. So this we can see very effectively, the utilization of that space can be seen very effectively in the urban type of settlement. So this is the end of that final development of the rural. And now we are entering into the urban. So the same space, how it has been developed or how it has been evolved in the urban, So again, the veranda remains the same, and the initial space for the this new room demarcates the space for the visitors. And again, we can witness that the off-centered door was maintained here. And after entering this particular visitors room, we can enter into the space. Now here, introduction of that chowk area, the courtyard area can be seen. So here we can see the passage, and from that passage we can see the influence of the north style of North Gujarat style of arrangement. So here they have some storage spaces, and after that they will be having that back room or the veranda space. So behind that they will be having the kitchen. So the kitchen from the start till the end, it remained to be at the rear of the building. So this kitchen, what they have done is like they will be having a small space in front, and this will be leading to the backyard. And in the backyard they used for drying clothes, washing clothes, and even for washing the vessels and all, they started using. And here this is a well for if we have two common dwelling units here. So one common well will be used by both the dwelling units. So here we can see the provisions for the staircase to the upper floor. And another one important thing is like in the next stage of development, this has been completely transformed, but without changing this core or without changing this basic things, they have developed according to their requirement. It will be like only the addition of the kitchen will be remaining the same, only this rooms will be added so that they can occupy this as a bedrooms and that kind of provisions, and this will be the same. And here one interesting feature is like once we enter into the space, so the person who want to go inside, they can directly go, and person who want to who came to just visit or to address these people, they will be accessing this space. And even if they want to access the first floor, they will be accessing this, and they will be coming back and they will be leaving off. So this kind of arrangement was existing in this particular South Gujarat. And next we are going to see about the tribal houses. And tribal houses is like more like South Gujarat, but again the dwelling unit will be like completely isolated by itself within its own agricultural field. So if we have a agricultural field here, and in that vicinity we will be having a small dwelling unit. So it was more like a agriculture based society. So the dwelling units were very simple and primitive. So they were also, they no any planned type of arrangement, they were just scattered. They all belong to the members of an extended family having a common ancestor, and their sense of belonging together is strong, but this is not expressed in their settlement pattern. So in case of North Gujarat, what we saw is like the community type of arrangement was very predominant, or very they focused more on that. But that was very less or not at all considered in this particular type of tribal house arrangement. And this particular type of pattern is typical for the Bills community, and they call it as the Bill pattern. And this is the end of presentation. Actually, it's time to ponder. So what we have to understand from this particular lecture is about. So we have totally three different types, like the Saurashtrian community, they had separate kind of arrangement from the settlement pattern, and from the dwelling units it vary, and for the North Gujarat it totally vary, and for South Gujarat it totally vary. Here what is the predominant factor which determines this is, apart from the climate, apart from the geographical condition, and apart from the occupation. So the major thing which influenced the architecture of this particular spaces is their lifestyle. So for the North Gujarat, they want their women community to be more secure. They want to maintain the privacy for them. So their plan is like more a kind of introvert. And while South Gujarat, their occupation and all differs. So their arrangement will be more somewhat kind of a semi-private kind of arrangement. And if you consider the tribal community and the Saurashtrian community, again it varies. So how the lifestyle have influenced the dwelling units, that we have to learn from these kind of arrangements. So the vernacular architecture is concerned or it reflects how the lifestyle of the people has affected their dwelling units and how the culture has bound them together. Like that we have